Well, Host Hotels and Resorts, which is one of the largest lodging REITs, announcing today the acquisition of its first hotel in the Florida Keys, Baker's Cay, for $200 million. This follows two hotels and two golf course acquisitions earlier this year for a combined total of nearly $1 billion. So joining us now to talk about the outlook for the industry is Host Hotels CEO Jim Risoleo. Jim, thank you so much for being here today. So you're buying up properties at a time when the travel industry was really going through some pain. What do you forecast the return on investment will be in the time horizon for some of these investments?
Courtney, thanks very much for having me today. We are very bullish regarding the return of travel in the United States. We are seeing a surge of leisure travel. We're calling it revenge travel today. And it's about deploying capital. We have three key strategic objectives in mind, and they all go to one bottom line goal, and that's to enhance the overall EBITDA growth profile of Host Hotels and Resorts. So as you correctly pointed out, we've invested $1 billion to date in 2021 at a very attractive EBITDA multiple of 14.3 times. The most recent acquisition, Baker's Cay, was acquired off-market. And based on 2021 estimates, we expect to earn 6.2% on our money, and that equates to a 14.5 times EBITDA multiple. As very attractive metrics, is a $300 2021 RevPAR. We expect this asset to generate $69,000 a key in EBITDA. It will rank number 8th in our pro forma 2019 portfolio. So the Keys are a very attractive place to invest in hotel real estate if you can find it. It's the number one upper upscale RevPAR market in the United States, but and that is driven in large part by the fact that there are very severe restrictions on new growth, new hotel supply growth. If we look at the period from 2000 to 2019, there was 4.1% supply in Florida Keys versus 25% in the U.S. Lastly, this is a light new asset. It was completely renovated with a $63 million renovation. And it just opened in 2019. So it's brand new. It has no near-term capital needs. We see a lot of upside going forward with this particular investment.
So, Jim, your portfolio is made up of a lot of luxury or high-end lodging properties. What is it looking like right now, and what is your forecast going forward for that luxury high-end traveler if business travel is still fairly restrained?
You're correct on the business travel side. It is restrained, but we expect business, both business transient and group, to start picking up after September. As the kids get back into schools, as offices open up, as people get back to work, we expect to see group business and business transient come back. In the interim, we're blessed with a very strong portfolio of resort properties in the Florida Gulf Coast, in Miami, in Hawaii, in California, and in Arizona. And candidly, these assets are performing above 2019 levels. So it is truly revenge travel. Our Florida resorts, we own three fabulous resorts on the island of Maui. They are running, they ran for the month of June in the low 80s to low 90% occupancy at ADRs that were above the same time in 2019. So the consumer wants to travel. You know, once the vaccine was rolled out and it became safe in people's minds to travel again, we've seen a surge of it. And we expect that to continue through the rest of the summer.
Are you worried about the Delta variant, or do you think it'll prove to be just a blip on otherwise a straight path to normalization?
Well, we certainly hope that the vaccines that have already been administered will continue to effectively deal with the Delta variant. There's been a number of stories published with respect to Pfizer, Moderna, and J&J that they effectively do block the Delta variant from causing serious illness and death. too soon to say that that is, in fact, going to be the case. I'll follow the science and hope they get it right. I have great confidence in our medical community in this country and in the pharmaceutical industry, given what we've been able to accomplish to date with the vaccine program.